Peter Banura, the Chikuwe District LC5 chairperson, says the district's roads are in a sorry state. He adds that they received 1 billion shillings for road maintenance, but they lack proper guidelines on how to use the money.
I'll be very honest with you, they are in a sorry state, but we are planning as a district that as the rains subside, as the rains reduce, we have plans as a district because we got funds from the road maintenance fund, 1 billion shillings, money that government allocated to each local government. Money in the first quarter came, money in the second quarter also came in, so we have money for two quarters.
Banura further explains that Chikuwe district doesn't have a road unit, something that is greatly affecting service delivery.
Because we made notice, we requested the Ministry of Works to request to help us if we were able to lend us borrow some equipment from the center. If we can have a grader, we can have a wheel loader. In the meantime, as we wait for the road equipment that is was allocated for Chikuwe, we'll be able to help our people to have some road.
Government to speed up the process of giving us road equipment. How much we're getting funding from the government is not enough. Since we're using it to hire those machines, which is quite expensive. The state of roads in Chikuwe is quite alarming. This is the rainy season. People cannot move road, people cannot do their businesses.
Our farmers to get their produce to the market in time, to help our mothers who are running to the hospitals, so that they're able to deliver, they're able to bring life to this world without losing that life.
Alex Biansi, the Kabuya Sub-County District Councillor, notes that Kabuya Sub-County is the most affected and wants the ministry to expedite the process of giving them the road equipment.
When you look at the side of the road, Kabuya is one of the sub-county in Chikuwe District that has very many bad roads, very many kilometers unworked on. We presume and assume when these road equipment reach the district that a great work will be done in the district. We are happy.
All this has been revealed during the district budget conference for the financial year 2023-2024 held in Chikuwe Town Council. Meanwhile, Moses Agumu, the Chikuwe District Chief Administrative Officer, has urged district leaders to be responsible parents to their children.
And here we have many categories of people. I thought that I would not find Karamojongs here. Karamojongs are here. All tribes are here. And what do you expect? Let's be responsible parents. If we have reached this level, and I like what Honorable said, God was faithful that we were able to study. We were able to reach this level. What about the generation that is coming? Because the culture that I'm seeing, that's what I'm saying, if we don't change our attitude of me, myself, or with my children, then we are going to fail.
Story compiled by Godfrey Homoza for the news in Chikuwe District.